Hello students, in this fourth video, now we are going to talk about trust accounts. Now what does it mean by trust? Trust means the possession of certain assets are given to the benefits of others. Means the property is given in possession of someone for the benefit of someone. Who is a trustee? Trustee is a person in whom the confidence is reposed and the possession of the property is given in possession of a trustee. Beneficiary is the person for whose benefit the trust is formed. So, in case of trust, there will be three parties: the maker of the trust. The maker of the trust gives the possession of property to the trustee in whom he has a confidence for the benefit of beneficiary. Types of trust accounts. So there are two types of trust accounts. One is private trust. Private trust is created for the benefit of specific individuals, maybe for the benefit of wife or children. The person, trustee, makes a trust in favor of wife or children, for the benefit of wife or children. Those are called as private trust. Public trust is created for the general public. Those are charitable trusts. Okay. Now, when a trust account is to be opened, what precautions have to be taken by the banker? So, the banker has to examine the trust deed. So, trust deed is the document by which the trust is created. So, banker has to thoroughly examine the trust deed. Why the banker should examine the trust deed thoroughly? It will be helpful to the banker to know what are the powers and functions of the trustee. So, to know the powers and functions of the trustee under the trust deed, he should first examine the trust deed thoroughly. In case of two or more trustees, if there are two or more trustees, then in that case, banker should clearly get the instructions as to who is going to operate the account. If there are no such instructions, then all the trustees should sign the checks. Granting loans to trustees. So, the banker should check the borrowing powers as per the trustees. So, he has to check whether there are borrowing powers have been given to the trustees or not in the trust deed, and then only he should allow borrowing loans, etc. by the trustees. In case of death or retirement of trustee, so the banker should verify the trust deed in case of death or retirement of trustee. So, banker should check whether the surviving trustee alone he can act without the appointment of a new trustee. So, if in the trust deed it is mentioned that if one of the trustee dies, in that case another trustee has to be appointed, then another trustee has to be appointed. If it is not mentioned, if it is mentioned that only a single trustee or surviving trustee can act as the trustee without appointment of a new trustee, then the banker will allow that trustee to operate the trust account. So, the banker should verify the trust document, trust deed, in case of death or retirement of trustee. Whether the surviving trustee could act without the appointment of new trustee. In case of insolvency of trustee. If the trustee becomes insolvent, so the trust property of trustee is affected by insolvency, the creditors of trustee cannot recover their claim from the trust property. So, the trust property does not belong to the trustee, someone else is owner, but only he has a possession of that property. In that case, the creditor of a trustee from whom he has taken the loan, they cannot recover their claim from the trust property. So, trust property will be safe in case of insolvency of trustee. When the trustee becomes lunatic, when the trustee becomes insane or person of unsound mind, then the banker should not allow operations of the account by that trustee. Banker should not allow the transfer of trust money to the personal account of trustees. So, trustees will have just to hold the property for the benefit of beneficiary. They are not the owners of that property. Therefore, it is the responsibility of the banker not to allow transfer of trust money to the personal account of the trustee. Thank you.